Hello and welcome to the video by Productivity Spot. I'm Sumit Bansal, and in this video, I am going to show you how to use filter views in Google Sheets. Now, let me first tell you what filter views are. So here I have this data where I have the region, stores, product sales, and I want to analyze this data. But the problem with Google Sheets is that it's a great tool when you're working with multiple people and you are collaborating with other people, then I can have this same sheet being accessed or being edited by multiple people. But at the same time, if I make any change here, if I, let's say, sort the data or filter the data, then that change would also be applied for all the other people. And I don't want to do that. I don't want to change the underlying data. In that case, what I can do is create a filter view, which would mean that create a view of this data that would not make these changes in the underlying data. It would be something that would sit above the data, but that would not change the basic underlying data. So what I would do is I would create a filter view in this case, and I need to analyze what are the stores that are making less sales of product A in each region. So which means that I need to know in East region, what are the stores that are selling less than 500 of product A. So to do that, I would go to data, in filter views, I would go to create new filter view. And when I click on it, you can see that the theme changes. These are all black column and row headers, and this new bar comes up, which says the name of the filter. So I can, let's say, call this filter East with product A less than 500. You can be as descriptive as you want. And it is telling me the range would be A1 to F81, which is right in this case. But if I want, I can change it here. Now this filter view is automatically saved. You don't need to click on a save button to do that. And now here I would create the view because as of now, it's the entire data. But what I want to do is filter the East data. So I would click on East here. And I want to know which of these stores are selling less of product A or less than 500 of product A. So I would click on filter by condition. Here, go to less than 500 and I click OK. Now, this is the view that gives me that these are the stores that are performing low in product A, but it doesn't change the underlying data. So if you have access to the same worksheet, so same Google Sheet, then you can come to this Google Sheet and you would still see the entire data. Now, another thing with filter views is that you can easily share your views as well. So here, if I come to the URL, you can see at the end, for each filter view, it would add something like FVID, filter view ID equal to this, which would be unique to each filter view. So I can simply copy this and I can send it to other collaborators or people who can view this or edit this sheet. Now, if the other person can edit this sheet, they would get access to this filter view and they can make changes to the filter view. But if you only send it to someone who has viewing rights but do not have the editing rights, then that person would be able to see this. They would be able to change the filter view, but their changing the filter view would not change the filter view at my end, which means that if I have created this, I have the edit rights of this worksheet and you have the viewing rights, then your changing the filter view would not edit the filter view for me. It would remain the same. And you would only see it temporarily, and when you close it, nothing would be saved for you as well. So you can easily share this with people who have edit and viewing rights, and you can create multiple of these. If you want to access these filter views, you can simply go to data and you have a list of filter views here. If you want to close a filter view, you can click on this close icon, and if you want to delete it, you click on this gear icon on the right and click on delete. Similarly, you can rename this, which means change the name here. You can update the range, which is here, and you can duplicate this in case you want to create multiple filter views. So in my case, if I want to create this for each region, then I can simply duplicate and change these values. So these are how you can quickly create filter views in Google Sheets. Now, one more good way of using this is, let's say if I create a new sheet here, what I can do is I can take this filter view URL and I can create a hyperlink out of it. So in this case, if I use the hyperlink formula and I specify the URL within double quotes and I type the text in double quotes again, the text that I want to show in the cell, then it could be East with low product A sales. and I enter this, now this has created a link, and if I click on this link, it'll quickly take me to that filter view. So you can see it quickly took me to this other sheet where the filter view existed in the filter view mode. If I close this and the filter view is not activated, and I come here and I click on it, it'll bring me here and activate the filter view. So this is a great feature if you're creating a dashboard or a summary report where you want people to simply have this access to click on these links and quickly being taken to the filter views. So you can do that with the hyperlink function. So that's how you can use filter views in Google Sheets. I hope you found this video useful. Thank you and have a nice day.